Hi, I'm Gareth Morris to you, coming from Lake Okaraka with Dan Jones. Dan, how are you feeling today?
Yeah, I'm feeling very good. Thanks, Gareth.
Fantastic. It's 2 days until it all goes down here at Tarawera.
Yeah.
Feeling confident, looking forward to it?
Yeah, I mean, the build-up went all right. Got COVID a few weeks ago, but past that now and feeling like the body's bounced back all right. So, hey, we'll get to race day and just take it as it comes.
Yeah, it's not the best. So many runners, friends of mine have got COVID recently. It's really not the best. And a shout out to my mate Carl, who unfortunately can't be here because he has COVID as well. So,
sorry, Carl.
Stepping back a little bit, you know, I think you've got a marathon PB of 2:16:19 or something back in the Oceania Champs in 2019. You don't just rock up and smack out a 2:16 marathon. What was the sporting background that got to you to that point?
Yeah, there's a lot of endurance in my past, and I grew up running.
Yeah.
I went to university over in the States for running, then I swapped over to multi-sport, like, again, just a big endurance base, and then I got the running bug again, and I stepped into the, I guess, marathon running space, I think 2018, and had a decent debut over in Gold Coast of 2:20, and yeah, I thought, well, that's a decent first go at the distance, so if I can improve on that, then there's that opportunity, potential to get to a world like a representation standard for New Zealand, and yeah, I went for it and ended up doing 2:16:15 seconds. Missed out on that World Champs qualifier by 15 seconds.
Ouch.
Yeah. As it goes, but you know, you have to. I think as athletes, we're always striving for something more, and you do have to appreciate that. It was a 4 minute off my first marathon the year before, so you know,
that's a hell of a gap to break out in such an important event. You know, we've seen you win quite a few marathons around New Zealand, but also you're really well known for, is it now 6 Kepler challenges you've won?
Yeah, 6, yeah.
That's an astonishing record. Can you see more Keplers in your future as well?
You know, I guess I get asked the same question every year when I cross the finish line. Will you be back next year? And it's like, I mean, it's such an amazing event. That's why I've been 6 times in, you know, in the past 6 years. So
yeah,
I'd love to be back, but it's all about putting together a calendar year that kind of suits a big schedule, and this year's going to be no different. It's going to be a huge schedule, so it'll all be about where I am in the world, where I'm at in terms of my recovery or preparation, so we'll see how it goes. I just take each race as it comes.
There's some really exciting stuff coming out, I think, this year. So you had that 6 Kepler. Was there a kind of natural transition to trail? Had you always been a trail runner who happened to run marathons, or was there kind of a point where you decided that was something you wanted to try?
Yeah, so it was just something I wanted to try, going to the marathon. I thought, I'll give it a shot. And my first goal was, maybe I can break 2:30, and training was going right. So I thought to myself, I'll go for something a bit sharper. And yeah, it worked out. And so then I thought, I gave it a good crack, and then, you know, COVID happened, and everyone's got their own stories around that. It did put a dampener on my international marathon running experience, I suppose.
Yeah.
And so I wasn't able to get to the quick races, and yeah, I was basically a big handbrake on things. So I didn't get to break my PB, or I'm still happy with my PB as it stands. But that is basically how the transition over to the trail really came about, or the ultra running really came about.
And living here in New Zealand, I'm a transplant. I moved here just about 9 years ago from the flattest part of the British Isles possible in East Anglia. And it's wonderful here. We've got great places to run, even around Auckland, but particularly out near, you're Tauranga based, are you?
Wellington.
Wellington based now.
These
days. Some fantastic trails out there as well.
Yeah.
So last year, you just seemed to have this amazing year where you came to Tarawera, you won the golden ticket, you got to go to Western States where you got this top 5 finish, which is, you know, means you get to go back, and we'll come back to that in a second. Mm-hmm. And then it felt like on a whim, you went and ran UTMB and came, I think it was 12th. How did it feel to have this amazing breakout year, given the work you put into your running?
Yeah, and to be honest, it didn't come easy. In 2022, the year before, I gave it a good crack. I was supposed to race Tarawera for a golden ticket that year. I'd just come off a win at Kepler, and then the weekend after, a win at Auckland Marathon. And I was in really good shape, and I tried to push that fitness through. which I think was a downfall. Yeah. But in the end, I went over to race Canyon's 100K, and I probably just overcooked myself in training and didn't really give the race the respect it deserved. I was looking forward to Western States, thinking, oh yeah, get that golden ticket then go race Western States. But yeah, blew apart completely. And so 2022 was hard, but yeah, I can look back now and think, oh, bit of a cliche, bit of a learning experience, let's say. Yeah. But so heading into 2023, I got the opportunity to race here at Tarawera, and I wasn't going to let that slip, right? So I did everything I could, was in a good space, and just came out here, raced the day as it came. And yeah, we had some good battles out there, but I put together a race that I'm really still proud of. And it's it's one of those races that I look back on and think, my 2023, it was a success after that race because of that race, and knowing that I could put together an ultramarathon like that, it means like in the future I can look back and think, I build confidence, right?
Yeah.
And so then going over to Western States, I thought, well, I'm an underdog going into this big bloody race over in the States. Had a great Tarawera, it shows I can be up there.
Yeah.
I'll just go out and do it and see what happens. And the race went all right, it went good, but it wasn't perfect, and I know I can do better. So I'm looking forward to, you know, improving on those results as well.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. We see that success and it's like, it's an overnight success. No, it's not.
There's
years of hard work
and
effort that's gone into that.
Yeah.
So looking to Western States, it was actually pretty cool over there in 2023. Mm. Did you feel you missed out on the real tough conditions and the 40 degrees plus in the canyons? Are you looking forward to that?
Yeah, in some ways, I mean, yeah, you have to be a bit crazy in the head, I suppose, to actually look forward to harder conditions or tougher conditions. But, you know, you do hear all the stories, as you say. You hear about the 40 plus degree temps, and I think we still got warm, don't get us wrong.
Yeah.
But, yeah, certainly the amounts of, like, the survival mode, like the the just, you know, ultra trudging towards the finish, we probably didn't quite have that last year. So it'll be interesting going back this year, and who knows what the temps will be like, or who knows what the conditions will be like. I mean,
yeah,
just looking back, I still had issues in that race where I banged up my knee in the first like 20 kilometers and had to push through on a bit of a sore knee for a while. And it actually came right. Usual story in those ultras where even things aren't going to plan, if you can mitigate, or you can try and get things under control.
You just push through and kind of
something else will come up, you know, and it's like, oh yeah, the old quad's hurting a bit now, or the calf's hurting a bit now, but you've got to just keep going.
You're running 100 miles. It's going to hurt.
Yeah, exactly.
So we've got Tarawera. I take it you're going back to Western States, give that another go. Have you got plans further out of the year you can talk about, or is that all still not quite to be determined at the moment?
Yeah, I think everyone changes their plans no matter what they, you know, no matter what they say. Yeah. But I'm looking to go back to UTMB. There are races that I'd like to compete in Europe as well, because I haven't, apart from UTMB last year, I haven't really got to explore that side of, you know, the trail running sport or the community as much. So it'd be cool to go back there and do some other races as well. It just, it all kind of, just depend on how I recover from each race and what the build and fitness looks like in between.
Yeah. It's going to be a really exciting weekend of racing.
Mm.
Feeling ready, feeling fit. Have you got a plan in mind, or are you just going to take it as it comes on the day?
Yeah, I think you go on with a plan. I mean, you set your race plan around nutrition and estimated times, but being the course is a new course, well, different from last year, different from any other years, it's very hard to put time goals into place when, there's different vert involved this year, there's an out and back involved, so we'll take that as it comes, but in the end, just going out there to be competitive and see what the body brings.
It's going to be quite different.
Yeah.
Dan Jones, thank you so much for your time.
Cheers, Gary.
Best of luck on Saturday. Really looking forward to seeing you smash it out there on the trails.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cheers.